Chewelude, kaido aro, kaido aro, soniade, kaido aro, ekimoku. Chewelude, kaido aro.
What does that mean?
Odewaye, odewao, amuyi tajubo. This way, as we're going out for a particular event.
Okay.
This is what we received when we came back.
Okay. Yeah. I understand that part a bit. It's the beginning.
Shewelude, kaidoaro.
Shewelude is more or less like vibrating, we call it shekere.
Okay.
But in Ondo, it's like, as Shekere used to make a very easy sound.
Yes, sir.
So you have to walk like that.
Okay.
Walk easily or walk
okay.
peacefully.
So that's Ondo language.
Ondo language.
Oh, amazing.
Kaido Aru.
So
when it tell you Kaido,
yes,
Kaido man, Kaido in Kaido Moitun, they don't want it from Kaido, but she Kaido. That is, take it easy. Take
oh,
it
thank
easy.
You. Now, you've played for all sorts of people, and many people may not know this. King Sonny Ade was in a Hollywood movie. Did you ever know that? You know? I'm going to give you this if you can tell me the name of the movie. Since you know. Not the name of the movie. Tell you right now. You don't know. Sir, you are in a movie. You actually played it. I almost fainted the day I saw it online. I'm like, because this was after our interview in 2010. So I'm like, he was in a movie and I didn't know. Why didn't I ask? So I went to get it off the internet. I mean, I'm hoping the owners of this movie will allow me to play a few seconds to make the point. I mean, and if you ever want to sue me, I was honoring King Sonny Ade, you know.
I know he won't sue you.
Oh, yes. It was a movie called O.C. and Stigs. O.C. and Stigs. I'm going to drop, I'm going to come and sit down there. We're going to drop a few seconds of it for you, so that you'll see it in the studio. O.C. and Stigs. Drop it. Can you see white people, not albinos? White people.
White Americans.
Sir?
White Americans.
White Americans.
Others just thought of him as that old bum who wandered around in the Schwab t-shirt.
They hear the guitar from the background. They hear the guitar. Sing groove. Sing groove. Sing groove.
Let's check a little mix up as well.
I've already forgotten my lines, you fool.
Winkele, oh, winkele.
Oh, people don't know. Oh, great. All right. I need to ask him the question. Please put your hands together. Come on. many things happen to you. You are sitting in your house one day when this guy comes from London and says they're looking for somebody to replace Bob Marley, and then that was you. I mean, how did this one happen?
Well, when they want to take that, they want to shoot that film. It's about two boys, and they became a rebel against their family.
Yes, sir.
So the father is owner of a nightclub, newly built nightclub, but his wife is always drunkard. She drinks a lot.
Yes, sir.
So and then they call people to come and rejoice with them, opening the nightclub. But unfortunately, the band disappointed.
Okay.
Them. So these two guys came to Mexico to come and meet me. And they saw me where I was playing, and they said, okay, you have to come to America. This and that's how the lyrics were.
Yeah.
So, then they now told me that this is the situation. They want to surprise the father, they want to surprise the mother, and they want to surprise everybody. So the people who are expecting probably American bands or their own kind of music. And then all of a sudden they saw another different people, and they were so constant. And then at the time within 2-3 minutes, they now got to use it. And they started dancing.
Yeah, if you keep watching the video, they all go on dance floor and everybody starts dancing. So, it becomes a party.
But at the end of the day, the family loved them. What they've done, that's never happened. It's a new thing that happened to them.
Okay, was this because of your links to the American record labels or the British record labels that you came by this?
Well, I would say so. And again, from my manager.
Okay.
Yeah, my manager, Andy Franco.
You have just done awesome stuff. Yeah, awesome. This is an American movie.
I thank you.
Amazing. Okay. You know the good thing about this episode? You guys are just what you are, audience. It's just me and him. We are grooving. We're just trying to carry you along. You're just helping me live out one of my fantasies. After this one, you're just leaving. We're going to play another song. I'm going to ask you one other question. Yeah. I'm going to give something else away. And then we're going to take another break. We'll come back. This time around, I'll be giving away what we call boutonnieres, or, you know, the flowers that you put on your lapels, from David Hopkins as well. King Sonny Ade is getting this. I'll also be giving that away. These boutonnieres, or boutonniere, or however the French call them, to KSA. We have this beautiful green, greenish type one, the red, the yellow to be worn on the lapel. And I'm also going to give same to any member of the audience who can get it. And I'm sure. I almost feel like not doing this one, because I know that Wale Olukolo knows this song. So I may as well carry it and come and give you now. And I know you'll be about the only person. I'm hoping that at least two other people know, so I can share it and give you one. Song number four that leads me into the next question. The next question is a bit personal one. I'll be taking it from KSA's book. Okay. By the way, you have a fantastic handwriting, sir. You wrote this for me in 2006 with Peace and Love from... I need to bring it closer to the camera. His handwriting is unbelievable.
Thank you.
Can you see that color? Just this one. Can you see that? Have you got any color? It's like calligraphy. For one who left school so early, let me even ask you now before I go into this. How did your handwriting get so good? You left school so early to pursue music.
Yes. First of all, I thank God for his mercies on my life. I love cursive writing.
Yes, sir.
In those days. Any book that has a cursive,
yes,
I love it. I just love the way it's being written. So from there, I started trying to write that way. But when I was in primary five, there was a teacher who came one day and said, let me see all your books. We started giving him that books. And he started throwing it away. Then he said, all your writings are not okay for him at all. He only took few. Then he said, I don't want to mention those who have those good ones, but you're going to start again. Then he told us to buy exercise.
2B.
2C.
Is it 2D?
It's 2. It should be 2C. The one that has a line, red line.
Yeah, 2D. 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 It's
2D. 2D. Yeah, so he has to start from A, then you go back again, then you go back again, then you cursive this way, that is A. So I started with my own. S, go, come back that way, come back this way, then you have to go follow, then come back again, write again, until you get Y, on the last one is Y, then you got Y, why go again to A? So
amazing. Okay. I mean, no rush. We're taking it easy. By the way, I need to let you know that he came all the way from Ondo State for this. Came all the way from Ondo State for this. Having played in Lagos over the weekend, he left yesterday to Ondo. Then he said, hi, he had to come and do this for Teju. So he left Ondo this morning to be here. That I thank you. All right, this next song, you are going to allow me a bit. I'm not even going to stand like that. I'm not even going to stand. I'm going to allow it to simmer. This, for me, sir, is your excellence at the strings, at guitar. The instrumentals of this song are unbelievable. When I hear this, it is soul. It is African soul. Every time I listen, I'm like, how does a Nigerian know to play the strings like this? How does he know to join the instrumentals together? I mean, this is blues. This is Yoruba blues, African blues. So we're going to lilt it. It's going to play a bit because I want you to get into the strings. The beginning is good, but unless you get into the strings, you're not really going to get where I'm going. So I want you to get into the strings. So we're going to let it play. Frank, play one of my best songs.
Yeah. Teju